Hallå, för dig, en tack så mycket. Ja, den kan jag inte tänka han på. I really hope the sound is right this time. And I'm pretty sure it is. Because I can hear myself. But okay. So, let's just simply continue and start the investigation of Moku Ikusaba, most likely. Or, no, Kyoko Kirigiri. As Byukia thinks. I hope it's not Kyoko. Oh, this song. To start off, I guess I will check the Monokuma file. As a result of severe damage caused by an explosion, the identity of the deceased is unknown. The explosion occurred post-mortem. The deceased suffered a single knife wound to the abdomen, extending to the back of the body. There are signs of trauma visible on the back of the deceased head, which appear to have been caused by a strike from a cylinder object, approximately the same diameter as an iron pipe. Okay. Additionally, there are numerous wounds visible in multiple locations on the deceased body. However, these wounds were not incurred in the last few days, but some time earlier. Figures. Even the Monokuma 5 won't reveal the identity of the victim, huh? Yes. That identified body actually crazy? I don't know. I don't think so, though. Or... I have to find out myself. Yes. I have to see it with my own eyes. In any case, if the truth doesn't come to light, we will be all be killed. Let's go to the garden, the scene of the crime. Where did Monokuma 5? When this song plays, you will know that shit goes down. Alright, let's go and take a fine tooth to go. Come to anything and everything that seems suspicious. I just need to think. Do the same thing I've been doing up until now. The total investigation should tell me once and for all whether this is clear or not. Okay. Red toenails and a tattoo. I don't think Kirigi had fake toenails. Because... It looks like there is something attached to the curved fingernails. These are fake nails. And they are fairly long too. Yeah, she had the gloves on. You can't have fake toenails with those leather gloves. So this is not Kirigiri. They almost seem like they would get in the way. Fake nails. Plus on top of the right hand is a tattoo. It's hard to tell because of the bands. It appears to be a dog of some kind. It appears to be a white wolf. I don't think I've seen design like that before. The red coat the victim is wearing is completely burned. On a part of it is left. The lower half of the body doesn't seem to be wet. When the corpse was on fire, I threw the butter on the burning upper half of the body. That's why the lower half isn't wet, right? The upper half of the body is burned black from the fire caused by the explosion. Also, the upper half of the body, where it is burned, is wet. When the corpse was on fire, I splashed water on it. Since I only threw water onto the burning upper half, it makes sense that the lower half isn't wet. In other words, there is nothing strange about it, only the upper half being wet. Is it? I have a strange feeling that this is not true. Oh, we don't have any time. We don't have a time. Okay. Right? When did we found the body? I don't remember. But it was day, okay. What did they after the explosion into the RQID? Can I check her head? No. Shoes? No. But it looks like something Kelly would wear and it has high heels. It's the same. Not good. Step away from the body? Yes. Let's see this thing I wanted to check. Look at those fragments of some sort. They are burnt, so it's hard to say for sure. But I'm pretty sure I've seen them before. But where? Was it there? It's actually a good idea to check the dump later. The loaded fragments near the body. I have no idea where they were. This is a knife. There's a knife on the ground. I'm guessing this knife is the same one that was in the body before the explosion. And the force from the explosion sent it flying. According to the Monokuma 5, the knife would extend from the other one all the way from the back to the back. Which means that was the cause of death, most likely. You know, I feel like I've seen this knife somewhere before. Yes, you did. Could it be? Yeah. A knife the first person had. Something smells kind of fishy. There's way too many similarities. The last person who attacked me last night had his knife in their hand. And then the same knife shows up here, sticking out of the stomach of someone in the same mask. In which case, could the reason be this masked person ended up getting stabbed? Be because I stole the knife in the heat of the saga, and then if we assume the masked person murdered here is Kirby, then that means the person in the bus who attacked me last night was also Kirby. But why wear a mask? I have no idea. I don't remember anything that happened last night. But still, there's no way that could have been me. So, this was my question. Why didn't the killer just put the body in this flower? The Monokuma flower. It would consume it. I wonder if it's true that it can consume garbage and plastic and humans in the event. It doesn't seem to have been used in the murder, so I will just keep my distance. Are the chickens safe? Put the chicken coop, there is chicken safe. For what? What is missing? Wait, for? What's up, nerd? Let's say, Mihalkura, I've got a question for you. Do you remember how many chickens were in this coop?
I most certainly do. Exactly 5.
Oh, really?
What's wrong?
I'm missing. There are 4 chickens here. Did he not eat one?
What? Oh!
That's weird. I wonder why it went missing. When I checked in on them yesterday, just before night time, all 5 were there.
Oh god, what should we do? 5 turning into 4 is a closer problem for the fabric of the universe, dude.
It's like a jigsaw puzzle. Even just one piece missing and the universe remains forever incomplete, dude. You know, in Harakura, could the chicken going missing have something to do with this murder? I don't think so. But why not? If I'm not mistaken, this was the control panel for the sprinkler system. The sprinklers are set to go off every morning at 7:30, and it can be reprogrammed. Hold on, wait. Given that the sprinklers go off at 7:30 AM, the course was here before then, it would naturally be wet. This means the murder took place after that. So I wasn't the one who killed him. Killed her. Okay. That's out of the way. Let's look in the shed. Not a really good idea to investigate the shed too. It is optimized, seems like expecting a random nation. But hold on, there's a white vinyl sheet here. Were the vinyl sheets in the shed before? No. It might have something to do with the murder, so I should check, at least check it out. Everything else is pretty much the same. The front side of the vinyl sheet is filthy. Dirt and mud everywhere. And it's soaking wet. It's wet and dirty. On the back side, it's completely clean. Not even a drop of water. It's kind of peculiar, huh? So, okay. I see the point of this. When I see dirty that on the side. Look at my right vinyl sheet. That's about it for the things I wanted to look at here. Okay, let's speak to that buddy, because I don't see anything else to help us. Perfect timing, Nagi. I have a question for you. Question for me? About your alibi. My alibi? Give me your alibi for last night after 10 PM. I wasn't feeling very well, so I was asleep. But what do you need my alibi for all of a sudden? And for after night time became known as? And it's obvious, this murder could not have occurred before 10 PM last night. And how do you know that? He was most likely up here. I came to this garden just after the night time announcement ran last night. As part of my search for the others, so I could inform them about Monoko was being disabled. I came here to find Hakura because he spent considerable time in the garden these past few days. I can say for the certain that there was no corpse here at the time. Which is to say, the murder occurred sometime after that. Sometime after night time began, when I paid a visit to this garden. However, Hakura, Fukawa, Asahina, and I were all in the gymnasium together until morning. Huh? After meeting up with Hakura in the garden, we immediately went to the two girls' room. After that, the 4 of us went to the gymnasium. and began work on disassembling Malaku. As a precaution, we avoided individual activity during that time. We even went to the bathroom in Paris. In short, the four of us are perfect alibis. Okay. So, the ones who could have gone down the killing is me, Kirigiri, and Ikusaba Mukuro. And the one is on the ground is either Kirigiri or Mukusaba. Okay. On the other hand, the only ones without alibis are me, Ami, and Kirigiri. Assuming the cause belongs to Kirigiri, the only one without alibi. The only one without alibi is me. On top of that, when we went to the phone calls and assigners rooms, we also went to the bedroom. But there was no response. Now, where exactly were you? I was in my room, honest. I was just asleep before because I wasn't feeling that. With no one to confirm that you claim, that doesn't qualify as alibi. And you can really ask Q. Kirigiri. Yeah, I know. So, what's your next move? The body is not laid out in your favor. This is kinda bad, isn't it? For me to be the only one without an alibi. Akura? It's 11 o'clock right now, dude. Thank you. This time, you provided me with some information I wanted. So, the killing happened between 10 p.m. and 11 a.m. And the sprinkler is out of the question because we have the final sheet in there, the red final sheet. So it most likely happened between 10 p.m. and 7:30 a.m. Which could be have been me. So yeah. And I was trying to remember what time we discovered the body. The time we discovered the body, huh? I went back over my memories of the day, trying to remember what time we found the body. I woke up at 7 o'clock, the Monaco was morning announcement. I went to the cafeteria soon after. There I met up with the signer, that was probably around 7:30. After that I went to the gym, everyone else was. Then we moved to the headmaster's office. Fukawa, who went to get the biggest, found the body then. At that time it was... Oh yeah, Fukawa doesn't have alibi of the morning, but she isn't the killer if I go with that thinking that the killing happened at night. Look about what time is it? When we left the gym, it was a little before 9, so it should be around 9 o'clock. Oh yeah, it was around 9. Oh yeah, that sounds about right. The cops discovered at 9 o'clock. Sounds good to me. My work here is done. Thank you. How could I have work? There's not a lot of that, huh? No, it's one of the most important questions here. No. Incident timeline. Toko, do you have anything? Ah! After all of this, we still don't know who the body is. But whoever it is, I want black girls again. Okay, she won't look at the body. Hey Nagi, do you remember what the cops looked like before it blew up? I'm pretty sure. The face was covered by a mask and the body was covered by a lapcoat. There was a knife sticking out of the stomach and the clothes around the tire were covered in mud. They had apparently stopped bleeding, but the blood still hadn't dried. Tommy said that if we touched it, not dry blood, one chicken missing. Fake blood, okay. Makes sense. Tommy said if we touched it, we were likely to get our hands stained. Although it far much blood, there was no sign of any on the ground and around the body.
Yes.
Thanks for helping me, Bernardi. You were a really big help. Nice speaking to you, Asuna. I was able to remember what things were like before the explosion. So thank you too. Anyway, I think I've seen everything I wanted to investigate here. But it's still not over. There are still other places I need to be investigating. I need to go there, I don't know where. To figure out the source of these fragments I found. And I need to collect as much information as about Kirgis as I possibly can. Is that corpse really Kirgis? And if so... Was it Kirgis who attacked me last night? I will probably be able to answer those questions by finding out more about Kirgis. Next time, we will find out more about Kirgis and search for more clues. See you.